this is a massive, massive femur bone of, in all likelihood, a rhinoceros. And you can see this very rounded ball joint over here. And what would have happened is that this would have fitted into the actual hip. And what I'm going to do is I'm just going to stand up quickly and show you exactly how it all worked out to give you an idea how big this bone is and how it would have fitted into the hip. Now, I'm guessing it was one of the right legs of a rhino. And you can see here this ball joint over here would have fit perfectly into the hip area. And this here would have been a knee or an elbow, depending if it was a back leg or front arm. I guess all rhino have legs, though. They don't really have arms. And look at how big it is compared to my leg. Absolutely massive. Very cool stuff. And again, just more bush telegraph, more understanding of what's going on in the past. And that helps us to keep out of trouble and learn from the misfortune of animals passing away. We get to take a closer look at their anatomy and at their skeletons and learn a little bit more about how these fascinating animals actually work. Cool stuff.